Parental discretion is advised.
This show is brought to you by Slice on Broadway, supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza, sliceonbroadway.com. And listeners like you, support this show at patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow. Just wait, just wait. It is the Wrestling Mayhem Show, episode 552, starting celebrating our 11 years of podcasting and talking about professional wrestling. I'm Mike Sorg at Sorgatron on the Twitter. Talking pro wrestling on Tuesday night, as we do. The new and improved Mayhem Studio still in Pittsburgh, PA with me. First of all, he's back from his Toys R Us exodus. He has retrieved his nuts from Joffrey the Giraffe. He is Mad Mike.
First of all, Sorg, it's Jeffrey. They kill you if you say Joffrey, because that is Game of Thrones, and we only sell a few Game of Thrones toys. But yes, I'm back. I'm here to talk wrestling. I'm excited. We have a lot of things to talk about, Sorg. We have a lot.
Yes, we do.
We have four fucking weeks to kill before the Rumble.
That's so right.
We have a lot to talk about.
Welcome to the Vamp Mayhem Show. Also,
we don't have Vampiro on.
We'll get him back on some other time. I just want him getting back on to tell you to eat a bag of dicks again, because that was so delightful. I was so happy when I heard that. Also with us is the Rizz.
Hi, Sorg. Glad to be back.
The guy who may be going to New York City to meet the Great Khali. I don't know. We're working.
Maybe.
Please get a photo.
Maybe more than that. What is this? Wait, is that Great Khali artwork?
That is Great Khali artwork.
Oh, geez.
Wait, what would be more that? What more do you want him to get besides an autograph?
I don't know. He's the
everything.
One. He's the Khali super fan over there. Well, and
one.
This is only one.
Well, do you know IWC superfan Chris Spiker? Yes, we're on the board talking about him and Rizz maybe going on a Mayhem road trip together to go meet the Great Khali. So,
can you bring Khali back with you?
Yeah,
sure.
I don't think they make suitcases.
I don't think that's legal, but sure.
You can strap him to the roof.
I mean, he can hang out with your Roman Reigns buddy over there.
Sorg. I'm not sure the line on transporting a Punjabi over state lines, but anyways. Well, about on the couch, you already heard from him, is BC Steele, manager to the stars, commentator on the International Wrestling Cartel.
And Mark that wears his own t-shirts.
And wears his own t-shirts. There it is.
24/7.
There it is. Hey, welcome back to the show. Our first co-host guest of 2017.
It's always good to blow the proverbial load to start the year. So it's only downhill from there.
Got this out of the way.
That means you can last longer. Never mind.
So great stories, by the way, on Patreon about his encounter with Chris Jericho.
Yes.
Recently.
Yes.
What else did we get into?
Someone messing their pants.
Somebody messing their pants. You won't believe who it was. Or know the person if you don't know local indie wrestling. But anyways, it was a good story.
We also talk about Hatchimals.
And we talk about Hatchimals and get Mad Mike hyped up about Hatchimals, because apparently that's like your trigger word.
What was it Dudders wanted me to ask? What did you want? What do you do if it doesn't hatch?
You throw it against a fucking wall!
And if you'd like to reach him on Twitter, hashtag Hatchimal.
That's at MadMike4883, also at Toys R Us Problems. That's a real Twitter account. That's a real Twitter account. I'm not even joking. That is a real Twitter account.
That's amazing. Oh, and with us also on the couch is Mutilator Larry.
Hello.
Who built the wall behind me, by the way. So that got him a spot on the couch.
Now, I have a question, Larry.
Yes, sir.
Who paid for the wall? Because that is a hot topic issue.
It is?
Was it Kalisto?
Oh. Oh.
Pull the mic closer to you, buddy.
What was it, the 205 live cruiserweights?
As a matter of fact, I think it was Daivari.
Ah, excellent. Oh, yeah, because Daivari is a huge billionaire in the Gendergrounds.
That is,
that's good.
That's right. Yes. That's right. But Mutilator Larry, he is watching currently 205 Live, at least for the next probably 20 minutes of this podcast. And so we're going to get updates and reactions. And you say Tajiri already debuted, right?
So far, Tajiri successfully
don't,
beat...
Don't spoil! Don't spoil! Don't spoil!
You have to call
no spoilers!
Line.
Damn it!
I don't know what to talk
I about. I do a whole podcast on this shit!
This is my whole segment.
This is my whole segment.
And the mic, the thing just slowly, wah, 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 wah.
Anyways, this is your Wrestling Mayhem Show.
If Tajiri didn't win his debut match on 205 Live, what the fuck are we even doing?
He lost in 42 seconds.
That's right. That's right.
To Lesnar.
But this is your Wrestling Mayhem Show. You can check us out at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. You can follow us at Mayhem Show on the Twitters, the Wrestling Mayhem Show Facebook page, where we live stream this as well over live.WrestlingMayhemShow.com every Tuesday about 10 p.m. Eastern time. You can we have a little bit of pre-chat and a post-chat and everything like that, so you can drop in and catch whatever mayhem is happening over there. Are you still messing with that? I'm going to move this until you are done. But anyways, but also you can drop us a line at goodtimes@wrestlingmayhemshow.com or 412-20 wait, you want to try it again? You can email us at goodtimes at wrestlingmayhemshow.com. I love having an audience to help out here. This is great. This is the dream of the your mic's back on.
Say it was very high pitched too.
Say it.
Say what?
Say it.
In a high-pitched voice.
Good times?
Good times at WrestlingMayhemShow.com or the phone number 412-206-WMS0. Leave a voicemail on the hotline. No, I don't have all the graphics up or anything like that. We still have to rebuild all those. Also, shout-outs to our Patreon supporters. That includes Ed Burke, Christopher Bishop, Alex Cars, the Matthew and Jennifer Carlin's Foundation for Podcast Betterment, AJ, Bo Diggity, woo! As well as Bobby Snyder. Thank you so much for supporting the show. What?
Who's that?
Yeah, I don't know. Thank you so much for supporting the show. There will be some changes to the Patreon. Don't worry, it will be in your favor. May the mayhem favor you all. Check out patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow. Give a lot, whatever, to support the show and help us as we transition the show. Is that the dog? Is the dog? The dog's mad. Seriously. The dog's kind of mad. But anyways, go check out all that at wrestlingmayhemshow.com, patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow. So let's get into what.
Sorry, that was me.
that was BC Steele. Really? So. The agenda. I didn't really set an agenda because I figure it's been several weeks. We didn't do a real show. Mike hasn't been around for a while, so I'm sure Mike's got some wrestling things on his mind, including his predictions for 2017. Although a weekend might be cheating, I'm not sure.
Hey, we're only 3 days in, Sorg.
That is true.
I'm pretty sure that's fair and balanced. As long as this stuff didn't happen tonight on SmackDown or last night on Raw, I think I'm okay.
Okay. Did anybody's prediction maybe do that? But anyways, yeah. Well, let's get that out of the way, Mike. What were your predictions of for 2017?
Okay. Well, I have four predictions as I'm wont to do. The TNA prediction: Vanguard 1 will win a championship. I don't know how that's going to happen, but Vanguard 1 will win the championship. My WWE prediction, this year someone will hold the NXT women's title and the and a main roster women's title in the same year.
Okay.
My prediction for our show, for the Wrestling Mayhem show, is that we will have a luchador on the show and Sorg will have to ask a question in Spanish.
Oh, jeez.
Cool.
Oh, jeez.
I like that.
BN.
And my crazy outlandish prediction, two more WWE Hall of Famers will get involved in politics.
Two more Hall of Famers?
Two more.
Is that not including Booker T?
That is not including Booker T.
Are you suggesting Rhino Jesse Ventura is going to get into the Hall
of
Fame?
No, that doesn't include Jesse Ventura. I don't know who they are. I just feel that two more will.
I think it's going to be King Kong Bundy and Stan Hansen.
I'd vote for either of those. I think Coco Beware is going to be Secretary of the State. That's my prediction.
There you go.
Bird, bird, bird.
I hear it's the word. Since we have you, we got two people on here that weren't on the show for the Christmas edition. So do you guys have any predictions for 2017? We'll start it off.
I have a few. One being that Shinsuke Nakamura will debut in 2017 and get a massive push from the get-go. Possibly the Kevin Owens. I don't know if Nakamura is going to work with John Cena, but I do think he will get a massive push. He works a WWE style. It did not take him long to catch on. My TNA prediction is that they will move networks again in 2017. I don't know their actual...
Safe predictions.
Well, I don't know their actual TV contract, but I will predict that that will happen.
Does YouTube count as a new channel?
If they're only on YouTube, sure. I don't think they're going to be in existence. I would love to see them back on a main channel, just for variety's sake. I don't know if that's going to happen.
Hallmark.
And the Hallmark Channel presents... Watch
oh
this.
My god! I would love to see Broken Matt Hardy in a Hallmark movie.
Broken Matt Hardy, Alyssa Milano, and Meredith Baxter Burney star in
the death of Vanguard One.
Dun dun dun. The scene opens on a snowy driveway. I'm available for movie voiceovers, by the way. And my Wrestling Mayhem Show prediction is that all the way in December is that you will get blackout drunk and pass out. That is my prediction.
I don't know. I'm 2 for 2 right now.
That might not be outlandish.
Wait. Were you part of the watch party?
I did see part of it, and I went, wow, that is very drunk, man. I enjoyed you trying to read questions. All drunk people have the same thing. They're syllables. They're not words. They're just syllables that kind of sound like words. And those thoughts we have in our head, like, what does that say? They all come out. So it's like you tried to say all your words at once.
Right.
So, but
it's efficient. It's efficient.
It was very efficient.
I was very proud of that.
Yeah. pride is a word.
I think I handled myself expertly considering the levels of alcohol. And
we will be taking a GoFundMe for Sorg's new liver. If anybody would like to donate.
That's why we only do this once a year. That's why I do not get that drunk anytime.
Speak for yourself, Sorg. Oh,
Mike is supposed to be coming next month, so there's opportunities. There you go.
That's what she said.
Larry!
Yes, sir.
Do you have any predictions for 2017 in wrestling?
I do. I'm going to be that guy who says Kurt Angle is going to come back briefly, because, God, that would be awesome.
You say that every live show you go to.
I do. Every single one. And I get let down every single time. my other prediction is going to be that I think that the Vaudevillains are going to pair up with Jack Gallagher and form a group. And they're going to get a push because, I think they're going to be the next Wyatt family.
Sorry to track back a little bit, but there
so
was.
So would they be the Old Day? OLDE.
Oh, that's
Ooh.
Good. I like that.
There you go. Rob's falling back for a moment. Rob's in the chat. He's saying, "So is the Lifetime Movie Network too high rent for TNA?"
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Probably.
Yes.
Way too much money.
Because then you would need the girl that played the sister on Growing Pains, because she's in a lot of those movies, isn't she? Should I not know that, ladies?
They might be able to do a Christmas special.
No, we have to explain the difference between a Hallmark Channel and a Lifetime Channel movie.
Okay.
Hallmark Channel movies always end well. People fall in love. People find lost relatives. Yeah. Everything ends up well. You end up with a horse.
Think of a Hallmark.
Okay, so Lifetime is more fitting for them.
Yes. Lifetime is movie. Dean Cain murdering everyone on a boat.
No, that's not a movie. That's a documentary.
I thought
actually.
That was the movie with Big Show.
That was also an episode of Smallville.
It was an episode of Smallville?
Wait, wasn't that White Castle of Fear with Vader where the midget blew up the boat?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Is it? Was that a Lifetime movie?
Sorg, Dean Cain was Jack the Ripper on Smallville.
Oh, crap, he was. That's right.
That's a real thing. real thing. He
it's a real Smallville thing.
Yeah.
Oh,
I don't remember remember him being Jack the Ripper. Dean Cain's Jack the Ripper on Smallville?
He was Jack the Ripper on Smallville.
This is the wrong show. Anyways,
my third prediction. Oh, lost sound.
It might be here.
Okay.
Hold on. Oh, I got it. Ahead. Go for it.
My third prediction is that there is going to be a women's tag team division.
What?
Whether it's NXT or the main roster this year.
Okay. Hmm. All right. Do you have a Mayhem Show prediction?
I have a feeling that you're going to get blackout drunk on the Christmas special and bash your head off that vent.
Oh, that's going to be tremendous.
It's a lot more room for things to happen in here now.
Or
so.
That one.
Or that one.
There's so much more room for activities.
People don't get to see, but there are these. There's some ductwork in here, and I'm a little too tall for the ductwork that's in here. And now, now there's stuff like you see the giant dent right there, right? it's already happened.
That's a work vent.
How much booze would it take for you to wrestle Roman Reigns? That the cardboard cutout.
The cardboard like the Roman Reigns. Reigns. I'm gonna, as long
I was going to say, he's jobbed to that several times already.
As long as I team with Cardboard Hulk Hogan, that's still over there. Mm. Yeah.
Wow, you have all the main... Well, I was going to say main draw. I don't know. Forget that. Edit that out.
All right. Anyways, so we had the wrong people on here. I'm going to be trying something later tonight. We'll see how this goes, because I did venture through.
Does it involve
alcohol? It might. Actually, that might be kind of fun. So I'm going to try to watch Wrestle Kingdom. I literally don't know any of the matches happening.
Okada versus Kenny Omega, I think, is the main event.
Really?
I believe so.
Wow. Does that mean... Now, see... Here's something that that came up that... I think I shared this last week around stuff. AJ Styles and Nakamura happened at Wrestle Kingdom this week last year.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Yeah.
And now look, now they're both WWE and doing insane. Like, just a little perspective thing.
So you're saying
by the way,
time...
Sorg?
So is Kenny Omega? No.
No.
Well, they do run on yearly contracts, so.
Yeah.
No, Kenny Omega's firmly ROH.
Okay.
He's firmly ROH. By the way, Sorg, in the live chat, I have posted a link to Dean Cain's character in Smallville.
Curtis Knox. Oh, no. He has. He absolutely has. Rob says, Gallagher plus the Vaudevillains, the League of Extraordinary Gentlemen, right?
Yeah. Yes. Sure.
Yeah.
I'm okay with that.
Okay. Acceptable. All right. So look for or look back on the feed. I'll be live tweeting the Wrestle Kingdom. I don't know. Is there anything else worthwhile on there, Mike?
Oh, I don't know. Yes. I don't know what the rest of the matches are.
It's Wrestle Kingdom, Sorg.
It's Wrestle Kingdom. That's basically the thing. Yes. I know there's going to be an English feed. I was reminded of it because I was listening to a friend of the show, Dave Lagana, talking with Jim Ross on his podcast a few days ago. I was like,
here, I'm going to find the card for you, Sorg.
I'm finding it here right now, actually.
We're all looking for it.
It's going to be, I just know there's going to be an awesome flippy match. There's going to be awesome people getting punched in the face match and Kenny Omega and that other guy. So it's awesome everything that I want out of things. And thank you, Google Chrome, for like automatically translating websites so I can sign up mostly knowing what I'm doing. So that was definitely appreciated.
They asked for your social security number.
They did not ask for my social security number, but I did like that the PayPal did tell me exactly how much that was in English dollars.
Oh, Cody Rhodes is going to be on it.
Cody Rhodes?
Wow.
Cody versus Juice Robinson that I'm seeing?
Yes. Oh, Ricochet's on there. Yay. Shit, I may have to watch this with you, Sorg.
All right.
And Young Bucks versus Roppongi Vice. That should be fun.
Roppongi. I'll finally hear the thing that they've been singing on We Watch Wrestling.
Roppongi. You've never heard the Roppongi Vice theme song?
Nope. Only the other people singing it. So
it was on ROH.
Wait. This one tag team is actually called the Bullet Club B Team.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like. It's like NWO Black and White. Remember when
it's a self-admitted, like Okay.
So does that mean like Horus and Stevie Ray are involved?
Vincent and BK and VK Wall Street teamed up. That was the NWO.
Yeah,
Black
exactly. Yeah, hi Vince. Hi Vincent. 2017 resolutions: not do a project that involves Virgil for a change.
I hope you break that resolution. Half of that money. Oh, I hope all your projects involve Virgil. Every single one.
You're gonna get Are you gonna like Virgil voodoo curse me on this?
Yes, I am.
Virgil sex tape this year. Virgil sex tape.
It'd have to be a double tape because half the tape would be his arm. Arm is what I said. Arm. It's like a long baby's arm holding an apple. Arm is what it is. Arm. This is on the internet, right?
This is on the internet.
It's not like we're on Lifetime or anything.
No.
If we were, we'd be after Supermarket Sweep.
Shibata and Goto looks awesome. Such a good show.
Okay. Kyle O'Reilly, Adam Cole for the ROH Championship.
That's always nice.
Did I see Mike Elgin on the poster?
Elgin,
I'm sorry.
I don't know.
No, I don't think so.
I swear I did.
He's not on the poster.
Didn't he get hurt?
He's not on the poster.
Oh, maybe that's it.
Oh, yeah, he is.
Yeah, he's on the poster.
Oh.
Maybe he's in the New Japan Rumble.
That match where they cart out Jushin Thunder Liger again and a bunch of other old guys and Tiger Mask
and Yuji Nagata.
I don't know what
wow.
that.
Wow.
No, Yuji Nagata was one of my main characters in WCW versus NWO. Revenge.
Tremendous reference. Isn't Yuji Nagata like 60?
Hold on. Let's
see. Yes. I mean, he's got to be.
Let's see nearing. What Wikipedia says
honestly,
here.
The first match in Wrestle Kingdom is just amazing to see how all the old guys come in and they just start just sauntering to the ring, not even caring. And whenever somebody comes to the ring, they just look at them, stop what they're doing and look and try to help them in the ring. Cause you know, they're pretty up there in age.
It's like the
gimmick battle royal at WrestleMania.
I miss the gimmick battle.
I would so love another one of those.
Mm-hmm.
We are so due for a 90s gimmick battle royal.
With the pirate guy, right?
I'm talking with the goon. We need to bring in Abe Knuckleball Schwartz.
Okay.
Is Brockus still alive?
Tatanka was in the Andre the Giant one. That kind of counts.
Mountain Rock. We need Man Mountain Rock back. Techno Team 2000, which now would be outdated, which would be amazing.
Don't forget the Latin Lover.
Of course the Latin Lover, obviously. And about Jackal? We can get Don Callis back. We can bring back the Truth Commission.
Doink.
Well, we can have someone dressed as Doink.
Yeah.
The biggest thing I'm looking forward to, because being in Thailand, I got to see this guy everywhere. Do you guys remember that watch of the Doraemon segment from Wrestle Kingdom last year? The robot cat anime? That apparently had a movie coming out. That was the biggest WTF moment that I've ever seen in a wrestling pay-per-view.
Sorg bigger than
RoboCop.
Yeah.
That's really kind of along those lines, right? I mean, like the robot cat didn't wrestle somebody, right? Or come out to a match. They just kind of came out, danced on the stage, and showed a trailer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Fun gaming fact, by the way. In the upcoming Japanese version of Tekken,
mm-hmm.
there's going to be skins for New Japan Pro Wrestling.
Really? In Tekken?
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Huh.
I want to play Tekken again.
I want to import Tekken, apparently.
There was Tanahashi, Rainmaker, and I believe even the Bullet Club are making an appearance.
Oh my god, I want to play as the Bullet Club in Tekken.
Why isn't that here?
By the way, follow Rizz Plays Games on Twitch.
There you go. Rizz Plays Games, where the Great Khali wins the Royal Rumble.
Every year.
Best.
Or as Great Khali would say,
every year.
I can't. I'm trying to type Tekken and it's not working. There it is. Tekken 7 New Japan DLC will include Chaos and Bullet Club ring gear. Wow. Yes. Wow.
That's amazing.
But you probably have to be in Japan to buy it, right?
If only you could combine that DLC with the Super Mario Brothers DLC they did for Tekken, and you could have Kenny Omega fight Princess Peach.
That's amazing. Oh, geez. So there you go. Maybe Mike will have a Wrestle Kingdom wrap up at some later point here. So big news I thought was interesting. I feel like we should review it because it felt like a pay-per-view last week. The wild card finals that beat Raw in the ratings last week. So is this like some, Mike, was it you or somebody else on the group or something said that we're basically where we were with the draft, where SmackDown's doing much better, but I don't think SmackDown ever beat them in ratings. Back
no,
in those
I don't
days.
Think they, I don't think they ever did because SmackDown was still taped,
right?
Back then, but now that it's live, like
and a different network.
Well, yeah, that too. Different network and live, and it's not going up against Monday Night Football.
That's true.
You know, all those things are contributing factors. Plus, that main event, though, last week, holy shit.
Mm-hmm.
That triple threat match was insane. One of the best triple threats I've seen since Brock, Seth, and Cena.
Oh, wow. Yeah, there's people I saw on Twitter, people calling back to AJ, Christopher Daniels, and Samoa Joe, which was a big thing I know we were really into back in the TNA days. I think that did that main event a pay-per-view for like the X Division title?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That kicked off one of their episodes of TV too, wasn't it?
Probably.
I think they did a rematch.
I think they just showed it again.
Oh, wow.
Back when we believed in TNA, that's for sure.
Now, would that be arguably...
okay, Riz?
we is a loose term, sort.
would that be Baron Corbin's best match?
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, by far, not even close. I mean, that when I watched him, I went, "Holy cow!" Like he looked like he belonged in
there. He really stepped up, I thought, around the Dusty Rhodes tournament. Was okay. One of the big things, and I think we actually talked with them a little bit about when we did the KDKA at the Arnold last March, and yeah, it was like that's when things were clicking for him, right? And again, like okay, he can hang with who was in that match: Rhino, Samoa Joe, Finn Balor, yeah, I think like that was the first kind of like, oh hey, he's actually going to do something rather than beat people up for 10 seconds and that's it. But no, I think, you know, whether you take that for, you know, okay, he can go or he can at least hang with Dolph and AJ.
Yeah.
I think that was great for him.
The combo end of days zigzag move was tremendous looking.
That
was fantastic.
That was either going to be, holy crap, that was amazing, or holy crap, that was crap. Like, there's no in between. So to pull that off was pretty, just with the timing and everything of it. Man, I want to go back and watch that. I think I DVR'd it. So that was a really good
one. Well, he'll be on network in like a week or two.
Oh.
So, yeah.
I forgot they do upload.
Like, after about a month, they put up episodes of Raw and SmackDown. So.
And even this past, like today, they had Dolph Ziggler versus
Bronco
Corbin again, and that match actually was one of their best matches that they've had in this series of 500 matches they had together.
Yeah, that's another thing. I'm kind of concerned the whole we're just going to have a million matches with Dolph and Corbin now.
But
that's Dolph Ziggler's gimmick though.
But
he finds one guy, fights them for 6.5 months,
gets good at it though.
He gets good at it. Ultimately loses and then finds someone else.
And that's what's happening, by the way.
So now it's Kalisto.
Yes.
Right?
And so, this is the best incarnation of Dolph Ziggler, by the way.
Oh, yeah. Angry Dolph Ziggler.
I don't give a shit anymore.
We have angry Dolph Ziggler. We got angry old man John Cena. Like, we got... Like I was listening to his promo tonight, and it's just like, it's like, no, I'm going to kick your ass, and I'm going to beat you, and I do all this because I want to, because I'm John Cena. It made me kind of call back to The Rock. The Rock's like, no, I'm better for you because I'm better than you because I'm The Rock.
Yeah.
Right? Like, he's believing his own hype, which he has earned over 10 years. Right?
It's like when Hollywood Rock came back.
Yeah.
And he did a guitar solo in the middle of the ring because he's The Rock.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I wouldn't be surprised if John Cena goes back to rapping just because he can. Like, I would not be surprised if the go-home show before the Rumble, he just cuts a vicious battle rap on AJ.
Mm-hmm.
I would love that. Like, an angry, bitter, like the end of 8 Mile B Rabbit rap on AJ Styles.
I love you for
like,
that.
You reference. Don't know what the fuck I've been through. Like, just the whole thing. Just
we need
full B Rabbit on this shit.
They need to have Mekhi Phifer as the MC for that. And AJ has to respond in kind. There we go.
R-Truth.
There we go.
R-Truth.
Even though he's a different show, whatever.
Well, so, you know.
They can do a trade.
By the way, R-Truth's music is on Google Music.
Yes. Yes.
It and is. As it should not be. Half bad.
Yeah, his stuff.
It's good.
As a rap connoisseur, his stuff is very... I think if you take out the fact that, okay, it's R-Truth, he's funny, he's a wrestler guy, you're like, wow, this is really good. I mean, it's scary to think that, because I don't think people really expect that because he plays this goofy kind of what's up and just says what's up over and over. Now, does he have music videos out? Do you know?
R-Truth? No, I'm not aware of this.
I think he did back in the TNA days.
Okay, because I remember seeing something of a music video, but I don't know what the time frame was.
I think he has like a YouTube station, like a YouTube channel, where he just like raps in front of the camera. Like, just like places a camera in front of him and just starts rapping.
I'm gonna start
to his
doing
own
it.
Oh, beat. Geez.
Oh no. Oh no, there's an R-Truth for Little Jimmy on Ron Killings TV. Oh no, he has some music videos.
Oh yeah. I be like, take a ride with me.
Yeah, this is for real. Hold on, I gotta find this.
Can we blare this?
I can't.
Sorg, let's do a quick watch party on the I Be Like official music video.
I kind of want to.
Shot and produced by my dog, Manny Mac.
I don't even care if we get pulled from YouTube on this stuff. This is great. Hold on, I'm gonna have to bump this up. There you go.
I got no snare in my headphones, Sorg.
You getting that? He's not bad when he's like...
It's not that bad.
It's a lot brighter than I expected listening to it.
You know what this is? This is like the urban version of the John Cena, Justin, or Day in the Life video.
It kind of is. Somebody got a drone. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that flyover. Like, he's still doing like that whispery kind of thing, you know?
There's a... Oh.
Hey, it's the nerdy white guy.
That might be Katz that was on the show. Old G-Money?
Wow.
Do you think? Is it? Maybe?
It might be.
It might be. I know he popped up at the Performance Center. I don't know what's happening. It's just something about Little Jimmy. It's getting weird.
He covered, there was a, like, for a few years of rap, it was you have to hang out of a car, you have to whisper, and you have to have bad grammar. And he covered all three. Like, that's impressive.
This is,
there you go.
Hey, you know, can we call Plumber?
Like,
I want to start freestyling.
Fast forward in the future of Nelly.
Oh, it's funny because it's true. Oh, I can't wait for his
Is R-Truth even wearing Air Force Ones?
So who would be the be. You know, that's ironic because I was actually listening to Nelly in the car on the way here after I saw somebody hit a car and keep on driving.
Apparently around the corner, right?
Yes, oh my actually, God. Yeah.
He just has a random picture of him and Rey Mysterio.
In the music video for I Be Like?
Yeah, in the music video, because I have it playing on mute. And he just, I don't know what the lyrics were. It was just a random picture of him and Rey Mysterio just hanging out.
Oh, jeez. Oh,
can you call Plumber? I really want to start just rapping to this song.
Like, to Plumber?
Yeah, no, well, no. Like, I'm on IWC. No, screw it. I'll rap to Plumber. There's a lot of words that rhyme with plumber.
Okay.
So, I mean, I can.
I mean, like, if you want to start on it, we can send them this afterwards if you'd like. It is the internet.
Wait till I ask for a raise first. And then if I need to drive it home with this, he'll see the value and be no problem. I mean, plumber and bummer and summer. I mean, it writes itself.
Plumber, summer, dumber.
Dumber.
I can't say dumber. He's the boss. So
yeah, no, but you can say you cannot be dumber.
Then plumber.
Oh.
Wait, what's that?
Dumber than plumber.
Oh.
Oh.
I think I've got my entire 2017 of IWC shenanigans booked. Thank you. I may not make it till June, but.
Well, you know.
I kind of wish R-Truth would have cleaned up his backyard before he did this video.
Where do we go from there?
Because there's just some kids' toys in the background.
But he has kids.
He needs this job. I get it. But still.
Yeah. No, this is somebody else. Larry. Larry, how is 205 Live going?
205 has just ended, and I got to say that I think this is my new favorite brand.
Really?
Yeah.
And this is your first time watching it, right?
This is, yeah.
Wow.
And, yeah.
So, no spoilers, but what'd you dig about it?
I found 3.5 storylines that I liked in a matter of an hour.
Did any of them involve an English gentleman?
They might have.
Did any of them involve Alicia Fox?
That was the half of the storyline that I like. 3.5 storylines.
Okay, all right.
It was good. It was all right.
It's definitely probably like more like storylines than the Cruiserweights had in like the first like 8 years of Cruiserweight division, right?
Yeah.
So it's interesting.
And there's more storylines on this than there is in NXT right now.
Wow. No, that's accurate.
He's not wrong.
That's all right.
He's not wrong.
And by the way, Mike, I did watch that NXT from Japan. And other than they showed the same match again for the main event and didn't, like, I thought it was supposed to be an episode of NXT. I didn't realize it was like a special event kind of thing.
I told you it was a whole house show.
Yeah, which is fine. I mean, Nia Jax and Ox... Asuka.
Asuka. I thought you were going to say Oksana.
Asuka?
I almost combined Oksana and Asuka, which was all wrong. I'm out of practice.
That's not even close.
Nope.
Asuka.
What's Oksana doing now? Sorry, that's a whole...
Well, don't know. Well, that you're going to hear from Bobby now. You're going to hear because he's the one. If anybody's looking out, it's him.
Bobby's ears just twinged right now, and he has no idea why. He has no idea.
His hatred level is up, and he doesn't even know what the heck happened.
Does Oksana have a rap video out?
No. Oh. She might have other videos out. We're not sure.
Oksana.
Like what? Wait. No, sorry. Like what videos? Oh. I don't get it.
Oksana, safe search off.
Yoga.
I bet she has a hatchimal.
Hey Alexa. God
damn it, Oksana.
Search for Oksana videos. She's holding it up to her ear. She's I don't know. She's like this. She's like dancing with her echo to her ear.
The first thing I see is GIF of Oksana's wardrobe malfunction on Raw.
Hulk Hogan's ex-wife starring in new rap video. Skip.
I'd be like two
with R-Truth.
The remix. With R-Truth. There you go.
With R-Truth and 45-year-old Nelly.
This one's for Bobby.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, I thought it was Rump Shaker at first.
It has to be his ringtone.
Is that Kenny G?
Okay, that's enough.
No, that was Oksana. Every time Oksana, are you aware of Oksana, Larry?
No.
Oh, okay, here we go.
You didn't miss.
All right.
Oh,
she was this very Lithuanian girl.
How can you be very Lithuanian?
No.
Well, you can be mildly Lithuanian,
like with the accent. I mean, and every time she would come into the room to seduce Teddy Long, who was the general manager of SmackDown at the time, that music would play.
That's
like,
funny.
Like, not coming to the ring, although also coming to the ring when she later wrestled. Oh, Oksana's here. And everybody would like look around because the music was playing. Like, and they heard the music.
I think that was a Mama's
Sorg, family. Hold on. You missed the money shot on Oksana.
The
reason Oksana... No, the reason Oksana was able to stay in the WWF was because she got fake married to Goldust to get a green card.
Wait, did that really? That was a real thing. I know, but didn't that marriage stop like as soon as they got married?
Yeah, yes, she turned on her. She turned on him like immediately, and then nothing happened.
It was like I do nut shot. Ted DiBiase laughed, and that was it.
Oh, that's right. Ted DiBiase married them, right?
Yeah. Ted DiBiase married them, and Ted Jr. walked away with Oksana to have DiBiase party posses, I think.
Party orgies.
Oh, no. By the way, I also like when we talk about wrestling storylines, and you're like, no, this is a real thing that happened, like, coming together, so.
Yeah. And by the way, first Ted DiBiase party potty reference of 2017. You're welcome.
Mm-hmm.
It won't be the last. It will not
also,
be the last.
Oksana is the one lady who did bring in Antonio Cesaro.
That's right!
The professional rugby player, Antonio Cesaro.
That's exactly right. Good call, Rizz.
So Oksana has an amazing eye for talent.
And to
She's a scout for NXT now.
There you go. Well, I was going to say, because the interesting thing is I'm pulling this up, and this wedding is actually from an episode of NXT.
Yeah,
it's from NXT, the game show version.
The game show version with the girls, that one. Oh, Goldust has the $1 million belt. Okay. And the entire Rhodes family is out there. So that's and all the girls. So, wow, wrestling.
That was a thing.
Wow, that was a mm-hmm. thing.
That's a weird time.
Yeah, that was also when was it AJ was hooking up with Hornswoggle?
No, AJ was hooking up with Primo.
Primo, that's right. Yes.
What?
Yes, that's a thing too.
Caitlin was the one who was hooking up with Hornswoggle.
That's right. Okay, I knew one of them was. Wow. I knew one of them.
Why am I knowing this right now?
Why? Were you like the last person to keep watching NXT when it went like off the rails and on the internet?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, jeez.
We didn't even start talking about Betamax, which was half sparkly but half scary lucha ghost.
What?
No, Betamax. Come on.
Isn't that what was out before VHS tapes?
No. Betamax was a group on NXT consisting of Derek Bateman, aka Sparkly Butt, and Maxine, aka Scary Lucha Ghost.
That's true.
Yeah, that's right.
These are all real things.
That Bateman guy.
That Bateman guy. What has he done lately?
I don't know. Took on a hardcore Bob.
He took on a hardcore Bob.
Probably selling some World's Strongest Man cologne.
What?
Yep.
Wait, what? Sure.
Smells like Mark Henry.
You never saw that.
Smells like Mark Henry.
I would love
never,
that.
Sorg, I'm sending you this right now.
What is he? I like he just leaves. He just.
No, I'm still here.
Where does Rizz go? What happens?
No, like the only promo Derek Bateman had on Raw was just of him as like this doctor.
Okay.
And it was a commercial for the World's Strongest Man cologne. And in the background, you can hear Mark Henry giggling like a little schoolgirl every second he talks.
Is this around the time where Fandango showed up before he was Fandango and poured milk on himself on SmackDown?
Before that.
It was before that?
Okay. Well, even when he was still on NXT.
You wonder why, out of all of those people, he's the one they still have.
It's only a matter of time.
It's only a matter of time. It might be. I don't know. They got squashed pretty quick tonight by American Alpha. But
is Tyler Breeze still a thing?
Yeah, no. Didn't you watch the Fashion Police?
I missed it.
The Fashion Police.
They took on American Alpha. They come out in sexy cop outfits now. And
that's
who
that was.
That was Fandango and Tyler Breeze.
Son of a bitch, I gotta go back and watch the highlights.
I love it.
I didn't know that.
I love it. All right. Man. Well, welcome to Random Mayhem Show. Having a lot of fun with BC
Steele. This is what happens when we have 4 weeks to kill him before the Rumble.
I mean, too bad there's not like a pay-per-view. I mean, we've gone we're going to go 6 weeks almost without a fucking pay-per-view.
And man. See, we say that, and yet we're going to have 6 weeks in a row where we have like 5 pay-per-views.
Yes.
Yep.
And no. It just doesn't work. This they need the to calm space before this the better. Storm.
What's that?
This is the calm before the storm.
It is. It
which
is
a great show name, by the way.
There used every to be day, a... every day is a pay per view for us for WWE.
There you go. We're here with BC Steele.
That's me.
Your podcast.
Awkward silence at one Woo! SF podcast.
Yes,
where I talk about life, liberty, the pursuit of happiness, drugs, and sex. Sometimes. And wrestling.
And wrestling.
Yeah.
Mostly.
And I complain on Twitter about everything under the sun.
That happens. That does happen.
Do you have pizza at your podcast, sir?
It's literally me, so sometimes I do, but I eat the entire thing by myself and then immediately have regret.
I just wanted to point out, I noticed another high-profile indie wrestling podcast has a pizza sponsor. I wonder where they got that idea up in Cleveland.
Rip off! Rip off! Excuse me.
I mean,
sorry.
I think somebody picked something up.
Our pizza's better.
It's not as good as Slice on Broadway.
No, not as good as Slice on Broadway. It's been supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza for a good long time here. Check them out at sliceonbroadway.com here in Beachview, Carnegie, PA, or down at PNC Park, home of the Pittsburgh Pirates. Let them know the Mayhem Show. Let them know the Mayhem Show sent you. We'll be back.
Sidekick Media Services. We are your sidekick in business for social media, video production, and more. Find out more at sidekickmediaservices.com.
We are back, Wrestling Mayhem Show 2017 with the crew, BC Steele, Larry, Rizz, Mad Mike, and the ladies are over there too. Hi, ladies.
What's up?
Sorg, on a wrestling podcast, you have to say it like Valvinus. Very manly.
What are you talking about, Mad Mike? That was like Valvian.
That was absolutely. You know, the ladies. Anyways, so now it's time.
Hi, the ladies.
Now it's time for the big question. Mad Mike, you got a thinker.
I do have a thinker. Okay. So I was listening to this other podcast, not wrestling related, and they were talking about how it would be funny if actors who have portrayed different characters switched roles in movies. I think it would be funny if the big question was, which wrestler would you like to have his gimmick switched throughout his careers? And you are not allowed to use Mick Foley. Because Mick Foley is too easy of an answer. Okay. So like mine, for instance, I will give you guys my example so you kind of get what we're going for here. I would like to see the characters of Oz and Kevin Nash switched. Like when Scott Hall revealed that he had a buddy coming to the NWO, instead of big sexy Kevin Nash walking out, it was a giant man with a smoke machine behind him called Oz.
All right. So to review, if you... somebody that had multiple gimmicks, if you could switch the gimmicks in time periods, what would they be? Does anybody have one lined up here? Have you?
I got one.
I say it's a thinker.
The exact career would remain the same.
Yes.
They would just be in so we're
saying,
different gimmicks.
We're saying Oz was in NWO and Kevin
Oz
Nash.
Oz is the guy that powerbombed Eric Bischoff off the stage.
Yes, which makes that funny. Actually, that does make that funnier.
Oz was the guy who lawn darted Rey Mysterio into a trailer.
Okay, all right. You know what? I got one.
Okay.
Swap Smash from Demolition.
Oh, I like this.
With Repo Man.
Yes! Oh, I love it. Here comes the axe.
Here comes the repo.
And you know what? Their name Demolition still works.
What did Repo Man steal? He stole something.
Macho's hat.
So now you got Smash. Right on Macho Man's hat.
I I really like this. I'm just picturing Barry Darso in that face paint sneaking around.
You ever watch an old Repo Man promo? There's a lot of subtext in there.
Oh yeah, there
there's
is
a lot going on. Like dude's like you know, working off some hard times on that one. So yeah. I can't even remember the rest of his he had like a lot of horrible gimmicks in WCW. So wait,
wasn't he Crusher Khrushchev?
I think he was. And wasn't he also did the truck match with
Blacktop Bully?
You know what? No. Put Smash there.
Too late.
Sorry.
No.
Your finger is off the chess piece. It is over.
That
Sorg,
actually,
Sorg, the only way I will allow you to change is if you change. If you want that King of the Road match to be funnier, instead of that being Dustin Rhodes, it's Seven.
Ooh, that gets kind of sad.
I was going to say make it Gold Dust, but that's even better.
Or Black Rain.
I was saying, which was the one with the rat?
That was Black Rain.
Any of you guys have him?
Wow. Well, I was going to say Gold Dust with Dustin Rhodes. I think to legitimately answer that question, I think Stunning Steve Austin would have been interesting. He wouldn't have had the same effect, but Austin before his injuries could actually go pretty well.
I was thinking that in WrestleMania 13.
Oh, ooh, God. Okay. That you know what? That still might have worked, though. That still might have.
He still had the blonde hair.
The blood from a stone image, if he still had the long blonde locks.
That'd be Ric Flair.
Yeah, he would look exactly like Ric Flair.
Now, would Colonel Parker still be with him in the ringside?
Oh, God, I hope so.
No, Colonel Parker would be managing Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. They can all be like super Southern together. It'd be incredible.
Although I don't know if they'd be able, I don't know if he'd be able to use the name Hollywood Blondes anymore because he'd be bald.
No. Or it'd just be ironic.
Or he would just have a blonde goatee.
Or Brian Pillman would just have to shave his hair and they'd be the Hollywood Balds. And they would have actually
yes.
They would have got it before Jimmy DeMarco did. So yeah.
What could have been?
All right, who wants to go next?
I need some time.
You need some time, Riz?
I need some time. I'm thinking about
there. Oh, no. Ladies, do you have one? Would you swap anybody gimmick-wise? Nobody.
Okay, wait, Riz.
What about...
What if The Undertaker and Mean Mark Callis switched?
Yes!
For all those matches.
I love it.
Same entrance, though.
Oh, absolutely. Same entrance. And instead of Paul Bearer, you get Theodore Arlong. With the do-rag I think he had on his head and all that.
Instead of Paul Bearer, you get Percy Pringle.
There we go. Ooh, this is
Teddy Long getting filled with concrete.
Wow. All right, you know what?
I'm surprised he didn't do that, too.
Hold on. He did. Instead of Paul Heyman, the current advocate for Brock Lesnar.
Oh, that's a good one.
Paul E. Dangerously with a giant cell phone.
Yeah. All right. I got one.
Yeah.
All right, go ahead, Riz.
How about... we switch out JBL's chief of staff, Orlando Jordan.
Oh no.
Yes. Not Orlando Jordan.
TNA's Orlando Jordan.
Yes. Riz. Oh,
come out with JBL. Just pouring this lotion all over his body like he always does. All
right.
Oh, God.
Just weirding him out every chance he gets.
Oh, no. I think Riz just described the Donald Trump cabinet.
Oh, 2017. We don't give a fuck about your politics. Okay.
I hope that happens at the inauguration. Orlando Jordan just runs
just
up on
Orlando
stage.
Jordan.
Well, maybe here, not so had a different connotation. All right,
hold on. I have another one. Let's take Broken Matt and Brother Nero and make them jobbers in Raw in 1996.
Dolph Ziggler in the Spirit Squad.
Dolph Ziggler and the Caddy.
The Caddy Nick Nemeth.
Papa Shango and Godfather.
Yeah, with the hose.
He has the hose, but they all have like painted faces, and he makes them like pass out.
They're just goth chicks.
That works.
Yeah,
that was the style. It was the 90s.
Yeah, I mean, you'd find a lot of them just swing by a Hot Topic.
Some of them are still there.
Yeah,
Christian and the Brood,
and some of them are the ones that have been there since the 90s. Oh, we got one. Hold on, let me get the lady mic up.
The lady mic.
You know what? That's never mind.
The lady mic has a mustache.
Producer Missy has one.
Hollywood Hogan, with the good guy Hogan from the 80s and 90s.
Can I one up you?
That would have been.
Can we swap Hollywood Hogan with Mr. America?
Ooh, even better.
They're two different people. Two different people.
Yeah, he says they're two different people.
He did take that lie detector test.
He did take a lie detector test. That is true. By the way, one of my favorite Hulk Hogan moments is the lie detector test.
Yeah. What about supposedly Earthquake and the Shark?
Oh no, guys. Oh no. Let's swap Earthquake and Typhoon for the Shark and Shockmaster.
What a team. What a team that would be.
What a team. They can be called Sharknado.
Oh. Okay. Wow. This is just specifically for Sorg. What if you switched Virgil and Curly Bill? You could make
it's
a
the same guy.
You could
it's
make
the
a
same
guy. Oh,
nothing,
no way.
Nothing changes.
Curly
right?
Bill hated rap. Virgil was a guy.
Actually,
Curly Bill had a cowboy hat. So
actually, the Million Dollar Man accompanied by Curly Bill would be amazing.
Oh, that would be great. What's that, Missy?
You could have the infinite change up when Damian Sandow did all of those different characters. Could you imagine those characters actually being drawn out as in the actual Damian Sandow character?
That's he would still be going.
He would definitely still be going.
Damian Sandow.
That's like a Doctor Strange time loop.
Planet of Infinite Sandow.
I've come to bargain.
Oh, jeez. This is good. All right. Well, let's know the answer to your question. Who'd you swap gimmick-wise? Let's know in the chat. Let's know at Mayhem Show on the Twitter. Let us know on the Facebook, wherever.
And
you may
no
find
Owen
us.
Hart jokes, please.
No Owen Hart.
No Owen Hart Blue Blazer jokes. Come on.
No, none of those. None of those. That's just wrong.
Mike.
Yeah. Hi, Sorg.
As we discussed, there is a hole in your heart and your soul.
Mm-hmm.
Because there was no 2016 Slammies in the WWE.
Yeah. It was a little disappointing because as a Slammy Award winner, I was looking to see who I would be passing out my legacy to.
Remind people how you received the Slammy Award, just for context.
I am a Slammy Award winner because one year WWE decided to give a Slammy to the best crowds, and I was a member of the Slammy Award winning crowd, and I would like to thank that I personally had a large motivating factor for that crowd being so raucous. It was a post-WrestleMania crowd where Dolph Ziggler won, cashed in and won the belt.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And and we as a collective won a Slammy Award. And it's a little disappointing that we didn't have it this year.
And Mad Mike can purchase his Slammy replica award on WWEshop.com, apparently. So the Slammies came back after a hiatus in 2008 and were steady until 2015. So it was a pretty good, like, for it to be kind of expected, was about right. Although not nearly as disappointing as the year as when the Slammies were simply an episode of WWF Mania, which is on the network, by the way. Yeah, I started watching that when I was going to watch
WWF Mania?
Yes.
Sorg, fun fact, WWF Mania took place in the same room where I had my interview for WWE.
That's awesome. That's great. But yeah, it is definitely a misconcept. Well, you talked about how...
And plus, we don't get the gimmick of someone walking around with slammies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love that gimmick. Speaking of Owen Hart made that shit work.
That was a pretty awesome gimmick.
That was. So we... Wait, oh, sorry.
I would rather have... Sorry to interrupt you, Sorg. I would rather have just a separate show on the network where it's just an award show, like what they did before. Mm-hmm. Just have the Slammies at like some event, like at WrestleMania. Have it at WrestleMania
week. Have it at the ballroom at the Holiday Inn down the road in Stamford, Connecticut, with everybody in suits. Still like, a gimmick, but in suits.
Like they used to do back in the day, where Jim Duggan got that was a big amazing. Fight.
That's right. That was my favorite
with
thing.
The 2x4 with the bow tie on it.
That's
come
right.
on.
That's right. Him and Harley Race, of all people, fighting all over the backstage.
what? Not to segue. Sergeant Slaughter and, what was his heel turn during the Iraq Desert Storm?
Sergeant Slaughter?
Was it still Sergeant? I thought you had
just. Yeah. Oh, but you just want to switch. You just throw USA and anti-USA.
Yeah. It counts. I mean, I think it counts as a gimmick change. So.
Hold on. In that vein, let's swap Rikishi and the Sultan.
Oh.
does the Sultan still dance? With that gimmick swap, though, you don't get the I want my country back, Sergeant Slaughter. What? Like the what? Rambo.
No,
version.
You do.
You do.
He just wants a different country back.
The Rambo vignettes that he had. Where Gene Okerlund was looking for him. If you need to look those up.
You could have him just wanting a different country back, and he could still be on the G.I. Joe series just as a member of Cobra.
Somebody's taking a phone call. I forgot where the door was. Yeah, that's the door. Did you not know how to get out of here?
Man, we did
Sorg, you've changed everything up in the studio.
We changed everything so much.
No one knows where the door is anymore.
Am I going to have a map when I get to your house, Sorg?
Yeah, you might. You might, Riz. Riz, you'll never leave.
I mean, I can't find my way out. You're gonna hold me hostage there. I don't know what's going to happen.
Riz, we have a large couch and internet. Look at that thing. You'll be okay. You'll be okay, and there's video games. You'll be fine.
That does look comfy.
That does look comfy. Yes.
It's a different couch.
Yeah, it is a different couch.
Where'd he go?
Where'd he go? He's the one that was trying to leave.
Where'd he go?
Just Larry. It's just us and Larry. No. It probably because we had a pretty packed December. With our pay-per-views. Although this, 6 weeks between Royal Rumble would be a nice spot for the Slammies, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it would be, Sorg, because that's what they used
to
do.
My mistake. I've totally ruined the flow of the show.
What's up?
Vince McMahon called me. He's actually listening in.
Okay.
He's suing me for uploading that IB or whatever that R-Truth song was. No, it was actually a wrong number. The person was very frantic, so...
Oh,
did they just get the green card?
Well, no, they go,
did you playing the Oksana video?
No, I don't think so. No. Did you tell them to listen to the Wrestling Mayhem show?
Vince does not remember who Oksana is.
No, I don't think
so. I don't know this number, but this is so-and-so. It says, call me right away. They go, okay, I need you. Who is this? I'm like,
it's Vince McMahon, damn it.
And they go, get that shit off. So I said, it was like, oh God, I have the wrong number. I'm so sorry. Bless you. And then hung up the phone. I'm like, yeah.
Call them back. Put them on speaker.
No, we're not
they
doing
sounded
that
very freaky.
It's the internet. It's fine.
It was.
Maybe it's the person whose car got hit down the road.
I hope so. Yeah. Well, that would be awesome, by the way. If that were.
By the way,
that was actually R-Truth's car. He's actually waiting outside.
Actually,
it'd be
Marvel.
He'd
be waiting.
And
Virgil was waiting outside.
Oh, that's true. That's true. Actually, you know what? That's who
that was.
He's
actually
on his way. Some asshole. In the trunk.
I swear. Somebody. That is my biggest fear. Is just like he shows up at my house during the show. So
yeah, he knows where you live. Huh?
With
no, he doesn't know where I live. He does not know where I live. I went to his apartment, and I went to somebody else's basement to film something. Yeah, there's a replica Slammy Awards. How much are they? That's Owen Hart's?
Like,
Owen
Hart's. What?
Officially licensed. Slammy.
But it's licensed. It's not his, right?
I don't know. It's got some fancy boxes.
Oh, no. How much are they going for?
They don't have fancy boxes.
Hmm?
300.
300? I think you would.
There's no info about them?
No.
They're used?
They're probably replicas.
They're used?
Yeah, I was going to say, there's no...
No, because I was going to say, you can buy a Slammy on WWE Shop.
Yeah, I was going to say, there's no certificate of authenticity on there. I would not pay $150 for that.
Apparently, guys, I'm seeing Bobby shared this. Apparently, the quote from Talking Smack tonight, as Dean Ambrose won the Intercontinental title from...
Dean
Kane. No, I did not say Dean Kane. From The Miz... I'm the freaking best. You and this company are plotting against me. I can't wait to watch this after this. But
I'd love if Dean.
By the way, Rob answered the big question. Just to cut back here, Sorg.
Okay.
He's swapping the Big Show with Son of Andre.
Yes, oh. I love it. I love it.
Oof.
I Man. Love it.
I gotta go call Vince again. That was horrible. Ugh. Oh, no, wait, that was a WCW gimmick. What am I?
Yeah, it was.
Never mind. I'm new here.
Oh, you know what would be really great? If we swap ECW Al Snow for Avatar.
This is getting worse.
Conan from Max Moon.
Wait, can we just... I retweeted this. This was a Meltzer quote from the 90s. When the whole standards and practices WCW thing, that whole thing went down, Conan would go out there and literally say... They're going to toss my salad and peel my potatoes. Like,
yeah.
We can say, for anybody that doesn't know, that means you're going to put your mouth and tongue places probably wouldn't go.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to lick from ball to back, but up. Anyway, he was saying that on WCW TV, and nobody had a problem with it. Absolutely nobody.
That's because they mainly broadcast in the South and no one understood Spanish.
Ted Turner probably wrote the script.
What's that guy saying? I love potatoes. Yeah.
That's hilarious.
Sorry.
Hey, he
has nothing to do with it.
He got a backward bandana on. He must be cool.
I think.
What does Ordele mean?
I don't know what all you were offensive to in that moment, but wow. Wow. Guys.
Hey, Sorg.
Yeah.
We need to talk about something real quick.
Okay. All right. Sure.
We need to talk about TNA.
Oh. Yeah, we do. Oh, yeah, we do.
When's Shane McMahon going to buy the company?
I don't.
At this point, it would be a losing investment.
They would have to pay him.
Yes.
Now that's a good businessman.
Tell me, Mike. Tell me how it is.
So Sorg, Apocalypto happened.
Shit.
Now before I get into it, the last two episodes of TNA were best ofs, but this past week's had interstitials with the Hardys, where Matt Hardy announced his the gender of his new baby via volcano.
Of course he did.
Because that's how you do it.
Yes. By the way, it's a boy, Mazel Tov.
Mazel Tov Hardy?
All right, I know you're watching, Matt. Mazel Tov Hardy is a great name. But no. So Apocalypto happened. It had... ODB came back to TNA for one match only. Hornswoggle teamed with Rockstar Spud.
Mm.
The Rock and Roll Express were in cranes. The three count reemerged, and then the Hurricane gained super speed. Lashley and Eddie Edwards fought in the woods in Cameron, North Carolina, for the TNA title, and there was no winner.
They're still fighting.
They're still fighting as we speak. Abyss killed a guy. Like, he killed several jobber indie tag teams.
I'm sorry.
No, it's fine. This is entirely laugh-worthy because it's exactly what happened.
I just thought of Anchorman. Abyss
killed
him.
Yeah, I know. I said it. Oh, I said it like Anchorman.
I had a trident.
Stepping the man.
Yeah. He had a hand grenade. He had a hand grenade from somewhere. It was fucking insane, Sorg. Oh, and by the way, King Maxwell pinned Rockstar Spud.
Of course.
So he's undefeated.
He's undefeated, and they did the Goldberg ending the streak finish because Senior Benjamin tasered Rockstar Spud.
They did!
And they stole Sasha Banks' entrance from NXT Brooklyn because King Maxwell came out in a Power Wheels Rolls Royce. All of this happened, and I couldn't even podcast about it because I had no idea what the fuck I just watched.
Why wasn't Coach talking about this on SportsCenter?
That should have been the lead story.
Yeah.
I'll be honest, I was watching this, and the better half looks at, she goes, "What's that?" I said, "Oh, this is wrestling." She goes, "Is it?" Because no. she sees Ricky, and she doesn't mean it in a rude way. She sees Ricky Morton in a crane, and I go, I can't stop watching. She goes, "What is it?" I go, "It's wrestling. It's TNA." She goes, "It looks like an old man up in the air." I go, "I know.
It is.
And it didn't hit me until just now how insane I sounded, because I don't know what I watched, but I loved it for probably the wrong reasons.
Mm-hmm.
And she goes, "Is that fire? Is that mm-hmm. a baby? Is that like it was all is that?" And then the one thing she laughed about is they said, like, "Yeah, get that boat," or something like that, when they attacked the boat.
Yep, the dilapidated boat, Skarsgård. Yeah.
And she goes, she started laughing. She goes, "That's funny." I go, "I'm not quite sure it meant to be." But that I would watch that every week. Like, I want to know who else is going to go up in a crane.
I would like to see it as an hour-long special. I think it was too long for 2 hours.
I agree.
Because they tried to they tried to do a whole lot.
You could put that on the Raw pre-show to make Raw more tolerable.
Actually, you know what? Make Raw 4 hours, and that can be the first hour every week. Raw Apocalypto. They throw another reference.
Raw Apocalypto.
A Techno Team 2000 goes up in a crane, and for some reason, at the very bottom, Tracy Smothers as Freddie Joe Floyd's hanging out there. And oh, man, I need to get a job. I need to write. I could be the next Vince Russo for not good reasons.
Vic Venom. It's not Vince Russo in WCW.
Oh, hardcore. We're going to have a baby angle every week. Mazel Tov Hardy's going to be. You know, when you said Mazel Tov, I actually thought that was going to be the baby's first name. I legitimately thought the first name was Mazel Tov.
It still might be. He named the first kid Maxel. That's not a word or a name.
Wasn't that another? No, I'm thinking, who's the one that Mickey James married?
Magnus.
Oh. Yeah, which is also not.
It's a name because it's Magneto.
I know, it's a wrestling name versus like they named the kid. Yeah,
Maxel. Like. Not like Maxwell.
Yeah, I was going to say, not like there's no W in there. It's Maxwell.
So an interesting thought came up.
God.
So Vince McMahon is going to the White House.
What?
He's going to what?
The White House.
Oh.
When?
Oh, good God.
Well, the news while we were off was that...
I'm going to kill it! With a lethal dose of poison.
It's like Vince McMahon unleashed the NWO in America. No, it's this is really going to be the year I don't give a fuck.
Wait, hold on. Sorg, who's the third man?
Hey.
Who's the third man, Sorg? Is it Schwarzenegger?
No, it's Barack. Or no, it's Bernie. He comes in.
Bernie does a. Bernie's going to be a swerve this whole time.
And then, like, Dan Rado comes up and he goes,
"Can stick it."
Oh, that was the best thing ever. Not the presidency. I meant the NWO thing. No. Let's.
Context here. Yeah, context here. But it is an interesting idea. And every time, I don't know how many times. And the stuff I listen to, it's like, you know, hey, you know, it was pro wrestling the whole time. We did an interview with the guy that on the Indie Mayhem show that wrote a book about this, right? But no, just kind of dawning
But Sorg, they booked it wrong. The heel isn't supposed to win.
Well, maybe we're not at the end yet. Maybe at the inauguration, he's going to like take off a mask.
Can we start a new podcast?
It's Mr. America the whole time. We're going to make Mr. America great again, brother. I mean, he has a lot of money now. Hey, I mean, that's what Doctor did for him.
Yeah, but do you really want to have a president that you've seen his penis?
Haven't we, though?
You know, You know what? You know, I will say President Taft had a pretty healthy one. So, has President Taft ever been referenced on your podcast before?
No, I don't think so. Yes. Nor his penis.
That's 4 or 5 Media. How you doing?
Can we? No. I got a pitch for a new podcast for the Wrestling Mayhem Show Network, where we talk about politics. But we talk about it as if we're wrestling fans.
Oh man!
So
like,
oh god!
We just go. When's Trump gonna turn? When's Trump gonna turn face?
Trump never turns. He's the mystery,
you know,
man.
This Trump angle has gone on about 9 months too long, you guys. We need a gimmick.
Yeah.
Change.
What's the blow off? Like, how does
they put him in a car?
If anything,
we're already
Donald
on
Trump blow office.
Aaron, you're already on an FBI list just for being on the show. Don't
Aaron
worry about
from
it.
Canada. Like,
but
as soon as Trump leaves, we go. Yeah, he's going to Russia. It's a done deal. He's going to Russia.
With Rusev.
With Rusev.
He's think going of, to Russia, and then Ted Turner's going to buy Russia. And
think of like all the WWE guest stars, and understand that one of them is president. So you could have like Freddie Prinze Jr. could be president in 20 years. One of our
big questions was actually, which WWE Hall of Famer would you prefer to run for president instead of Donald Trump?
Well, I'll go back to Coco Beware.
Drew Carey.
Is that too?
Drew Carey, yes.
Yeah. Bob Barker. Yes. Wait, is he a Hall of Famer?
Snoop Dogg.
How about Bob Backlund? Mr. Bob Backlund, yes.
Can we go back to which Raw guest host would you rather have than
John
Jeremy
Stewart.
Piven.
Kermit the Frog.
Oh, he wouldn't be the first puppet in the White House.
Oh!
Oh! Oh!
No puppet.
Man.
Oh,
Snooki.
God.
Snooki? No.
Nah,
just a woman's never going to win president.
She's about to be terminated by...
Chuck Norris. Wait, yeah, he was.
Chuck still alive?
Chuck Norris was a special referee.
Chuck Norris will never die.
No.
That doesn't mean he's not... This is an answer for question. Larry King will never die. It doesn't mean he's alive.
I think he's on his 12th wife, too. Larry King, not Chuck Norris. I don't know how many wives Chuck Norris has. Well, you only get one at a time. You don't, unless you're Mormon. And that brings us back to politics with Mitt Romney, because he was Mormon, or maybe still is. I don't know. I didn't ask.
What happened?
Not that we talked.
What was the original question?
I don't know what's going on anymore. Why is Vince McMahon going to the White House?
Oh, yes. That's right. Why is Vince McMahon going to the White House?
Well, Linda is
going
to work at the White House.
She's a billionaire, so yeah, she has a cabinet.
You don't
position.
Think he's not going to like hang out? I mean...
No, Vince is going to hang out there, and then Triple H and Shawn Michaels are going to piss him off by spray painting DX on the side of it.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes.
What's this? Grumpy Cat?
Grumpy Cat.
Grumpy
Guest
Cat.
Star of Raw.
Grumpy Cat hosted Raw. Yeah.
Yeah, it's true. It's a fair point.
Wow.
Oh, we should just have the Raw anonymous general manager run for president.
For president.
Wait, didn't
it's,
that...
It's going to be Hornswoggle.
I was going to
anyway.
Say, yeah, didn't that end up being Hornswoggle? So that would make...
Yeah.
You know, he couldn't.
But still, that would be progressive. That would be progressive.
Vince
will be in the White House because
Vince is his illegitimate father.
There you go. There you go. We got. Wait. What's going on? What's going on?
Yes.
Yeah, you with your hand raised.
RoboCop when you guest starred on WCW.
Yes.
RoboCop, next president.
That will be the Law and Order candidate.
No,
right
but
there.
But see, RoboCop's entire platform will be to clean up Detroit. That will be his entire platform.
That's all he
By
got.
By the way, going all the way back to what we were talking about before, RoboCop also has a statue.
Did it happen?
I think it happened.
Yeah. Where's the statue at?
Guys, I'm going that way.
The only movie that should have a statue is the Mighty Ducks. All of them.
Yes.
Like
Mighty Ducks 1
except
or 2.
For, all of them. Except for Luis Mendoza. Fuck that guy.
Why? Ow. All because he can't stop and you want to hate on him.
He can't stop and he's a fucking con artist. He tried to steal the dude's girlfriend in Mighty Ducks 3. Fuck that guy.
Hey, don't hate the player. Hate the game.
What?
No, I'm hating the player. I'm hating the fucking player.
So Linda McMahon.
She couldn't play hockey for a damn.
No, she can't. She can't.
She can't even take a tombstone.
Well, our president can't take a Stone Cold Stunner, so we're even.
Maybe that's going to happen.
Our president can't even react
yeah,
to the boogeyman.
Got, wait, Donald Trump got stunned?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
It kind of like looked
Mania.
Like he went to hug Austin on the way down and just collapsed. It wasn't as bad as Vince's first one where he had like a coronary on.
Right. I'm sorry. I'm looking up an article to see if the RoboCop statue
happened. Our president can't
happens.
Even react to the boogeyman properly. He had a segment with the
he
boogeyman.
He did no-sell the boogeyman.
Well, so
he
did Santino Marella.
He no-sold the boogeyman.
Has the boogeyman ever had another gimmick?
Not really.
No.
Old man Marty from Tough Enough.
Yeah. I lied about my age, Marty from Tough Enough.
Yeah, I lied about...
Is that him?
Oh my God, could you imagine straight boogeyman on Tough Enough?
Wait, like on the beach where they're doing all the challenges?
Yes.
Getting worms out of the sand.
Fuck it. That's what I want to do. Everyone that was on Tough Enough, I want them to have their wrestling gimmick, and let's reshoot Tough Enough.
Miz would win.
Oh, I have a new one.
Yeah, Mario the Moth, Johnny Mundo, bitchy announcer Josh Matthews, S&M manager Linda Miles, blind Nydia. We can redo all of this.
Son of Havoc.
Ryback.
Yes, Son of Havoc.
Can you imagine Son of Havoc going face to face with Stone Cold Steve Austin?
Absolutely.
Ryback.
Goddamn Ryback, yes. Oh, God. Damn it.
These are such
great ideas. Oh, wow. I just want to reshoot Tough Enough with everyone having their gimmick.
Oh.
Maven, I dropkicked the Undertaker once. Maven,
I dropkicked the Undertaker.
or QVC Maven.
He should have gone around telling everybody that he eliminated the Undertaker from the Rumble. That should have been his gimmick for an entire year.
Yeah,
wasn't it? I thought it was.
You know, it might have been.
Isn't that his gimmick on the Indies or something? Like,
no, he did a he did an infomercial for the cat pan that scoops the poop.
No, he did a lot of things for QVC.
I feel like Mabel's come up in conversation in the last year.
Mabel?
Like, that he...
There's that lawsuit or whatever.
Is there?
Yeah. I think it's kind of like with all the concussion ones.
Oh, he's in that one?
I think he
went to jail.
Well, because he passed away, but I think his wife is involved in that lawsuit.
As of February last year, the RoboCop statue had not been erected, and they were wondering what happened to it.
Well, that's some bull.
Yes, he did.
They have until May, as far as I'm concerned. Because I want to go see it.
Man, we need more statues.
Do you think Vince McMahon's going to the White House to negotiate Royal Rumble at the Capitol building?
Well, I heard...
WWE Capitol Punishment!
Ooh. Wasn't one of the stories that that Donald Trump really thought Vince McMahon died?
Yeah.
Yes.
He called
him. Oh, yeah,
called
him, yeah.
What an idiot.
His good friend.
That's the kind of person that will be running around for 4 years. Well, we'll see. But
what?
I'm just saying.
We'll see.
I mean, stepping
obviously,
down.
Obviously, you've been reading the political dirt sheets.
I do. Political Observer.
The feeling in the transition team is that...
Meltzer gives the inauguration 2 stars.
Yes, yes. We don't know. Wow. We don't know why diplomacy is not getting a hard push right now, but guys, let me know what you learned from wrestling this week.
And there are seriously a lot of Democrats in the doghouse.
They're going to get buried. It's a shame that there isn't a Triple H of like a Herbert something Hoover. Herbert Henry Humphrey? Hoover. I mean, granted, he's, you know, he's not really doing like, much
you,
now,
you, you just want like a yeah, somebody that
just,
you,
just to reference it.
Yeah. All right. What'd you learn from wrestling this week, guys?
I learned, this is legit, I'm not going to reference any 90s shows or anything. I learned that the booking of Bayley to the championship is similar, almost identical to the booking of Daniel Bryan. The only difference is, I think with Bayley they have the set plan where she's going to be the guy, or, well, the girl. Whereas Daniel Bryan was kind of, instead of following this to the championship, he kind of went here, and then he was over here. So learning that they're taking a formula that worked and using it again. Whether it'll actually work, we will see.
I'm always iffy with Bayley because I feel like the good development happened on NXT.
Yeah.
Right? Yep. Like her from the kid Bayley to becoming champion Bayley was that.
Bayley is a little too aggro for me on Raw. She's a little too, like, full of her own, like, she's too confident right away.
Right. Producer Missy, what did you learn from wrestling this week?
I learned that I still plop at the mention of Shawn Michaels and The Undertaker coming to Raw.
Say because pop. Raw is desperate for
say
ratings.
Say pop again.
No.
Say pop again.
No.
Please.
I think there was a problem with the microphone.
I think it's fine. Yeah, I think we need to hear that again.
Did the microphone pop?
I think it might have.
That's so cute. Katie, do you have something that you learned since I have the mic on over there?
I'm confused why you're calling me Katie.
Dutters.
Hi, I'm Dutters.
Are we hiding your identity on here?
No, I just don't like
her name changes with the various levels of sugar she's had.
Oh, okay.
Wait, Dutters like sugar? No.
Wait, what was that again?
Braun Strowman's head, if you turn it upside down, put the beard on his head, he looks like a troll doll.
Yes, there was some art that was being shared during the Raw wrap-up last night. Thank you for that.
Awesome. Fan art. By the way, thank you, Jesse. Thank you, friend of the show, Jesse.
Mm-hmm.
Also helped out with the fan art.
Larry!
I learned that I can't watch a Braun Strowman match without thinking of Goro from the Mortal Kombat movie.
Oh, wow. Those are $500 sunglasses, asshole.
Yeah, like, it's ruined for me.
He needs 2 more arms.
Where is it? They're in his beard somewhere.
There's a picture of Braun
Strowman. No, show him the other one. Show him the other one.
I cannot look at Braun Strowman the same now.
Nope. I also can't, like you know, the Braun Strowman from the other podcast.
Beef Stroganoff.
His Tinder profile is awesome, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I was just looking at that.
There's a story out. I wasn't searching for it. I swiped left. Or right, whichever's the...
whatever the bad one is.
What are you? I swiped left or right.
Turn that to the... I can't really... Yeah, there you go. There you go. Oh, hold on. I'll find it. I'll find it so I can show him in the feed. Riz, what'd you learn from wrestling this week?
Well, I was going to say... Braun Strowman really likes lifting weights and eating steaks. Hey. His actual Tinder profile.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Is there something else you actually learned? Or?
No, that was going to be it.
Oh, that's it? Okay.
That's a pretty good thing to learn, though.
That is acceptable. It's definitely acceptable. What about you, Mad Mike?
Oh, man. I learned that WWE is never going to change. No. I was watching, Sorg, did you watch that talk show thing last night that they did?
I did.
With Paul Heyman and JBL?
Oh, it was amazing. They butchered that dude.
It was, Paul Heyman and JBL were great, but any time something, they were way too positive.
Yeah.
About a lot of, I feel, legitimate problems within WWE.
Mm-hmm.
mm-hmm. and legitimate things that can be changed and fixed and addressed. And at one point, Paul Heyman just said, well, deal with it. It's not going to change. I'm like, wow, that I don't know if that's something you want to be putting on the network. Like, well, I understand it's supposed to be unfiltered and all that stuff, but
yeah,
ooh,
they were mentioning,
a little harsh.
They were pushing it as like, oh, will Hulk Hogan ever return to WWE? Will so and so be inducted in the Hall of Fame? What, like all these weird questions about like pushing like things you would never want to hear on WWE, and then having him go, nah, like so what. Who cares? It's what you want to hear.
What do you want to know? Like, is this thing going to happen in WWE? From two people that have no say in that thing ever happening in WWE was my take on some of the stuff.
Yeah.
So, it was interesting. I don't know. It seems like yet another show, like the Raw pre-show, pay-per-view pre-show kind of things, where people are talking in kind of I guess they weren't really kind of a kayfabe on this thing, but like it felt a little bit like they were going towards like the Legends Roundtable, then pulled away from it in feel of conversation. I don't know. I don't know if I like it. I don't know if I care for it.
It kind of just felt like a fuck you to anyone in the internet who talks about wrestling.
It was a little bit. Oh, hi.
It was a lot of it. Like they almost just basically said it.
Yeah.
I heard this and it kind of really summed it up. If you ever watched like Pardon the Interruption on ESPN, it was kind of like that, but with wrestling.
Oh yeah, it was.
And a lot of shame.
I don't know about that necessarily.
And a lot of shame.
There's contrarian opinions on Pardon the Interruption.
Sorry, there are people throwing things in here. I don't know what's happening.
I don't know. It was weird.
Is this chocolate going?
I'm working here.
What's getting thrown here?
We're going to throw stuff.
Rain.
After this will be the Wrestling Mayhem Show Chocolate Rain and Techno Party.
Chocolate Rain.
There you go. Stay tuned for the post show. I learned from wrestling this week. Sammy Zayn's the go guy. He's the next go guy. Like it all like really used to be, hopefully with a little more success. After that last man standing, and nobody cares anymore. They're just
Sorg, please don't give Sami Zayn Dolph Ziggler's career.
No. I think he's going to do a little better than Dolph did. But man, I thought that was a really good match, and really kind of made me Braun and made Sami awesome too. It was the best match I saw Sami in that did not involve Kevin Owens.
Oh yeah, and Sorg, I also learned that two spears are worse than one.
Ooh, there you go, ladies and gentlemen. Wrestling Mayhem Show. BC Steele, he's got a podcast.
Yes, he does. It is at 1SF Podcast. I'm also on the Facebook at 1SF Podcast. I am on MySpace I'm not on MySpace. But MySpace is still a thing, and if it were popular, I would be on that. I talk about mostly my life in professional wrestling. I also go on rants, topic of the day. And sooner we'll be moving into topics like politics, drugs, sex, and other things that people can hate me for. So follow me, and I will have Sorg on eventually.
Will you?
You're on my list. I've got like a list of 15 people, and there's I think 6 to go.
Is he on the list?
I'm on the list.
He is on
the
list.
You just made the list.
Yes, you just made the list.
Oh shit!
I have many lists, and you are on one of them.
Did you bring that list with him?
Huh? No.
No.
He did have a scarf though.
Yes, he did.
It's a very fashionable scarf.
The scarf was legit. Mutilator Larry, he's on the Twitter. That he uses it.
I have people for that.
If he has people for that, yes, he does. Oh, and he builds walls, wonderful walls. Do. Right back there.
You should break the walls down.
No, don't.
Oh, no.
Break down the walls of Sorgatron.
That's a horrible
one. That was not even... Nope.
My future as a guitar is gone.
Rizz is at is Rizz. What are you? Rizz Plays Games on YouTube.
Rizz Plays Games.
What are you, Rizz?
What you is?
I think I'm also another... on Boss Battle Podcast. Or...
Boss Battle Rizz, Podcast.
Rizz, what is your future as a guitar
or drums?
I'm more of like a cymbals guy. I'm not really a Maybe even like a triangle.
He's just the Clash in the Pan. All right, Mad Mike 4883. He does the midweek war. And spoiler alert, I'm going to start joining him over there.
Yes, and also be sure to keep an eye out for the hashtag MM for when I live tweet Lucha. Maybe TNA. I don't know what the fuck they're doing this week. We shall see. But yeah, Midweek War is coming back this week.
And I'll be joining on the 205 Live and the NXT editions of that. So
yes.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, producer Missy. Thank you, co-producer Katie. Dutters, as I get a mean look again.
The sugar's worn off.
Is the sugar worn off? She's back to the Katie.
Nobody knows she needs more sugar.
Nobody who says. Maybe we got more people. It makes it the show sound bigger.
It's like nobody knows Lunchbox as Will.
Who the fuck is Will?
There you go. What's happening? Every week it's a party here?
Don't
forget
we have Alexa.
We have Alexa. Did she start talking to you again?
No.
Yep, wait, Alexa Bliss?
If you want to watch... If you want to watch Dutters yelling at her Echo Dot for about 40 minutes on the internet, go over to the AwesomeCast Facebook page. That live stream is over there forever. And thank you, everybody, for joining us in the chat. Dan Hooven, Brandon, Matt, Rob, Erica...
Hey, that's probably somebody for me.
Thank you for bringing people. Thank you, everybody, for joining us on the stream. Checking us out on the podcast, WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Tuesdays live. Excuse me, hiccup. 10 p.m. Eastern time on the Facebooks on live.WrestlingMayhemShow.com. We'll see you guys next time. Hiccup. Mayhem out. This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com.